Hello everyone, this is a continuation video on analysis of time series. In the last video lectures, we have discussed the measurements of trend that is related to least square method, exponential method, right? And we have also discussed the second degree parabola, and then we have also discussed how to shift the origin of the trend, right? So let's take one full-fledged question on the shifting. Okay, so let's read question number 12. Trend equation for the yearly sales is given, and 1000 rupees for a commodity is this. Let's read question number 11 or 12. 11. The sales data for a firm over the past few years are given below. Years are given starting from 2012 till 2019. Sales are given in rupees. Then first they are asking obtain the straight line trend equation using 2015-16 as the origin. Right, that means we need to consider this year as origin. Then obtain trend values for various years and eliminate the trend component using multiplication model. And last one is that is we need to shift the origin to 2012. Okay, so let's do this question step by step. So we have given the year from 2012 till 2019, and we have also given the sales in rupees, and we have considered the sales value Y, right? Now let's solve this question with the help of the least square method. And in the least square method, we have equations Y equal to A plus BX, right? And you know very well how to find out the A value of A, that is sigma Y divided by N, and B sigma XY divided by sigma X square. Right, so that means we need to find out the value of first one, that is sigma x, that is the summation of this value, and that would be 358. Then we need x y, so that means we need to find out the value of x. So as given in the question, that we need to consider the 2015 year as origin, right? We need to consider 2015 as origin. So 0 minus 3 minus 2 minus 1 1 2 and 3, so which means the summation of x would be equal to 0. Now we need to find out the value of x square also. So 9 4 1 0 1, 4, and 9, right? So, we have given one more year. Actually, we have given the number of years in the even series. In the even series. So, that means we need to follow that step that we have done in the past, right? So that means 15, 16, hold on. They have asked for the 15, 16 year as origin, right? So 15, 16, that is 215.5, okay? So which means if we consider 2015.5 as origin, so the value of x would be 7 minus 5 minus 3 minus 1 1 3 5 and 7, and the value x would be, x square would be 49, 25, 9, 1, 1, 9, 25, and 45, and the sum would be 488. Now we need to find out the value of the product of x and y. X and y, that is equal to minus 189 minus 160 minus 117 minus 36 48 186 218 476, and the total would be 168, and this would be 488. Okay, so now put all these values in the formula. So that means the value of A would be 358 divided by 8 years, and that would be equal to 44.58. B would be equivalent to value of xy 488 divided by 168, and that is equal to 2.90, which means now we have the equation yc equal to 44.58 plus 2.9x. Alright. So this is the trend equation. Now first part is done, that they have asked for the obtain the straight line trend equation. So we have done this part. Now obtain the trend equation trend values for various years and eliminate the trend component using multiplication model. So that means first of all we need to find out the values of trend for all the years, that means from 2012 to 2019, and then we need to find out the eliminate, that means the multiplication model. So that means we need to make a column yc which represent trend, and the multiplication model. Right, so yc, that means and now just we need to find out we just need to put the value of x in the equation. So that means in the 2012 the value of x would be minus 7. So after putting this value we will get the trend, that is 24.45, 30.25, 36.05, 41.85, 47.65, 53.45, 59.25, and 65.05. Now for multiplication model, that is y divided by yc, and so the values would be 1.104, 1.057, 0.807, sorry, 4, 0.860, 1.007, 1.159, 0.945, and the last one is 1.045, right? So second part is also done. Now the last one, that is, we need to shift the origin to 2012. See, this equation is basically based on the origin 2015, right? 15. Okay. Now we need to shift the value to the 2012. So that means in the backward. So that means the value x of x would be minus 7. No, no, no. So that means we need to find out the new equation now. So that means yc equal to 44.58 plus x minus 7. So that means new trend would be 24.45 plus 2.9x, and here you need to write the origin is 2012. That's it. So here we get another trend for the origin 2012. Right? So this is the whole question, and I think you have understood this concept now, because I have done nothing new in this case. Now let's move on to next question. Question number 12. Trend equation for yearly sales in 1000 rupees for a commodity is y equal to 81.6 plus 28.8x. Unit of x, which is equal to 1 year, that means unit of x is given as per annual, and the origin is 30th June 2019. Okay. Now we need to adjust this equation to find the monthly trend values with January 2020 as origin, and find the values of March 2020. So first, just forget this second part for a while. First focus on the first part of the question. First of all, they are asking that we need to convert this annual trend into monthly trend, right? And the origin would be January 2020, right? Like as I told you in the last lecture, when they are asking about the changing, like from year from I think I have explained this part now. No, no, in the last lecture video we have discussed only the shifting part, not conversion part. Okay, so let's first discuss about the conversion from the very basic. Now let's discuss about the basic concept of the conversion. Conversion of annual trend. Values to monthly values. First of all, we need to understand this concept, like why do we need to convert the annual trend into monthly trend. See, whatever we have done so far in this particular chapter, we have analyzed the annual trend, like whether we have done the least square method or second degree parabola or exponential trend. These are basically based on the annual trend. Like that means when we are basically need to find out the trend just for a long time, like what would happen, like what would the sales value after 2 years or 3 years, right? Not for the very long time, but yes, like near to the current year, like suppose the current year is going on, that is 2021. So now I would like to know what would be the sales of my business during the particular session of this Diwali occasion, right? So if I need to want to know what would be the sales value in this occasion, I need to find out the I need to find out the seasonal trend, right? And that I cannot find out with the help of the annual trend. So for this, I need to convert the annual trend into monthly trend, right? So that means the basic objective is to find out to analyze the seasonal trend also. That's why we need to convert the annual trend to monthly trend. All right. So what do we do in the case of, that means how to convert the annual trend into monthly trend? This is very, very simple. Suppose we have the equation like this. Suppose let's write the equation first. This is y equal to a plus bx, right? So how to convert this is the, this is basically the annual trend. This is basically the annual trend. Now we need to convert this annual trend into monthly trend. How to convert? Simply that y equal to, now y represent the trend that is on monthly basis, right? So what do we do? Y equal to, that is a divided by 12 and then b divided by 144. That's it. This would become monthly trend. Now definitely the question definitely comes to your mind, so why you divide b by 144? So for this, first you need to ask yourself what represent a and what represent b, right? So a, this is basically the purely the constant value, right? But b basically represent you can say the time, you can say the monthly increment, right? Because it increase year month by month, so that's why we increase the b value basically depends basically represent the incremental value, right? So that's why I divide to 12 two times, that is 12 multiplied by 12, that is equivalent to 144, right? So this is the way of the converting the annual trend into monthly trend, right? And similarly we can convert this annual trend into quarterly trend also. So how to convert? Simply y equal to a divided by 4, b divided by 16. That's it. So we will get the quarterly trend. Very simple. All right. So this is the way of converting the trend into monthly or the quarterly. Just need to make sure that what represent a and what represent b. Why we are dividing the b two times, that is 2 times 12 or 2 times 4, because the b value basically represent the incremental value or the average amount of change per year, right? So let's take some example to understand this clearly. Suppose we have a question like this, that is yc equal to 30 plus 3.6, right? And the origin is suppose 2020, and x unit, that is equal to 1 year, and the y unit equal to annual sales. Annual sales. Now we need to convert this annual trend into monthly trend. Before we convert this trend into monthly, we need to understand this concept very well. That is y equal to 1 year and y unit equal to annual sales. That means both of the units, that is x and y, both of them are based on annual, right? If both of them are annual, so we just simply follow this method. That means in this case the YC would be 30 divided by 12 plus 3.6, sorry, yahan par this would x also 3.6 divided by 1 T4 x, right? So that means YC equal to 2.5 plus 0.025 x. That's it, right? Now let's take some more example. Okay, let's take one example from the second degree parabola. Suppose we have a question like this: YC equal to 10.6 plus 0.8x plus 0.64 x square. Right? So this is basically the annual trend. Now we need to convert this into monthly trend. So how do we do? That is YC equal to 10.6 divided by 12 plus 0.8 divided by 144x plus 0.64 divided by 1728x square. This is basically the cube of 12, right? That's it. Now we will get the monthly trend of second degree parabola also. 0.883 plus 0.0056 plus 0.00037x square, right? Now let's take one more example. Suppose we have a equation, this YC equal to 280 minus 1.8x, and in bracket origin is June 30, 2020, right, where Y unit is equal to annual, sorry, it is equal to monthly average sale, monthly average sales, right? This much information is given to you, and they have asked for that to convert this trend into monthly, right? So what do we need in this case? See, first of all we need to see like what is the x and what is y. Y is given in the form of monthly basis. So that means if y is given on monthly basis, we don't need to convert this variable, but we need to convert the x variable, right? We need to convert only the x variable, that is the independent variable or the explanatory variable, right? So first convert this trend into monthly. That is YC equal to 280. Now this 280 would not be divided by 12. Why? Because x is given here, that is on monthly basis, right? Sorry, that is y is given on monthly basis. So that means the x that is on monthly average basis, but we will divide only by 12, not by 144, because the YC equal to 280 minus 1.88x. We have given that the Y is the monthly average sales, right? Because it is already converted into monthly. But the X value is only divided by one time, that is by 12, not by 144. Because X represents the average amount of the change year in the annual values, right? So we just divide this value only by one time, that is by 12, right? So that means the YC would be equal to 280 minus 0.15x, right? Now suppose in this question itself they have asked like to shift the origin half a month forward. I repeat, to shift the origin half a month forward, right? Now simply the origin is given, that is 30 June. That means now we need to convert this origin to 15th of July. So what we do in this case, simply the new equation would be YC equal to 280 minus 0.15x plus 0.5, that's it. So the new equation would be 279.25 minus 0.15x, that's it. Okay, so this is the all basics about how to convert the annual trend into monthly as well as into convert into quarterly. All right, now let's do the illustration part. Now let's read the question number 12. The trend equation for the sales 1000 rupees is given to you. Unit of x, that is equal to 1 year, and the origin is 30th June 2019. First we need to adjust the trend to find out the monthly trend values will be the January 2020. So question number 12, the question is YC equal to 81.6 plus 28.8x. All right, and in the bracket is given origin 30 June 2019, where the x is equal to 1 year. Okay, x unit is equal to 1 year. That is, it is purely based on annually, right? So first we need to adjust this equation into monthly. So what do we do in this case? Simply YC equal to 81.6 divided by 12, right? See the difference between this question and the previous example. See, the Y unit was in monthly, that's why I have divided only by one time 12. But in this case the X unit is equal to 1, that means the whole equation is on annual trend. We need to convert the monthly trend, so that is plus 28.8 divided by 144x, that's it. So we get the new equation, that is YC equal to 6.8 plus 0.2x, right? So we have done the first part, right? We need to shift this origin to January 2020. Shifting to January 2020, how to shift this value? See, the origin of this equation is, that is 30 June 2019, right? Now we need to convert this we need to shift the origin to Jan 2019. See, in this case the specific date is given, but in this case the date is not given to you, right? The date is not given to you. So what do we in this case? We need to assume that this is the middle of the January, right? So that means we need to shift this origin till 15th of January 2020. So that means how much months we need to go to forward? That is 6.5 months. That is 6.5 months. So that means YC equal to 6.8 plus 0.2 X plus 6.5. That's it. So YC equal to 8.1 plus 0.2 X. Right? This is the new equation that is based on the origin 15th of January 2020. Right? Now moving to next question, that is question number 13. The following equation has been derived for the production of the steel. The origin is given, that is 2017. Time is equal to 1 year, and Y unit is tons per year. Rewrite the equation shifting the origin to 2022. That is, we need to move forward 5 years, then express the X unit in month and Y units in tons per month. All right. So let's do this question part one by one. The equation is, that is 10.27 plus 1.65. 10.27 plus 1.65 x. Yes. Now first they are asking for, that is shifting origin to 2018. That means the origin is, in this case, that is 2017. Right? So shift this origin to 2022. Right? So that means if 10.27 plus 1.65 x plus 5, right? So YC equal to 18.52 plus 1.65 x, right? So this is the part number one. Now part number two. Express the X unit in months and Y units in the tons per month. See, these all the parts are interrelated each other. That means this second one was based on the first, right? So that means after shifting the origin to 2018, we need to express the X unit in months and the Y units in tons per month. That means they are asking for converting the annual turn into monthly. That's it. So that is YC equal to 18.52 divided by 12 plus 1.65 divided by 144 X. So YC equal to 1.54 plus 0.0144 X. All right. Now moving to the third part. Find the value of Y for July 2023 on the basis of the equation found in first above. Okay, see, this equation, basically the origin is, what was the origin of this value of this equation? That is origin 2022. Now they are asking to shift this origin to July 2023, origin July 2023. That means they want to shift the origin to this, right? So what do we do in this case? Since we have given the month in this particular period, but in this the month is not given. So when the month is not given, what we assume? That we will assume that that would be the middle part of the year. See, when the like as we did in the previous case, that when the month is given, sorry, month is given, but the date is not given, so we will assume the middle of the month. But in this case, the year is given, but month is not given, so we will assume the middle of the year. That means we will assume that it would be 30th June 2022. Right, the origin is 30th June 2022. Right, and that means again the date is not given, so that means we will shift till 15th of July 2022. Now simply we need to take the difference of this, so the difference would be 12.5. Right, so third part, YC equal to 1.54 plus 0.0144 x plus 12.5. Right, so YC equal to, sorry, x, just hold a minute. Yes, so after the shifting we are going to find out the new equation, that is so that would be YC equal to 1.72 plus 0.0144, right? So here is the new equation after shifting to 15th of July 2023, right? So this was the question number 13. Moving to next question number 14. For each of the following, derive the monthly trend equation, shift also to a month. See, that is YC equal to this, origin is given, and both of these, that means X and Y, that are based on N1. So you just need to simply convert this value into monthly. So that is very easy. So that means this is this would be your homework. Okay, now moving to next, so that is second part, YC equal to 169.58 plus 78x, origin is 2015, where X is based on annually trend, but Y is on based on average trend. So what do we do in this case? In this case, we just simply divided by the that is 169.58 plus 78 divided by 12, right? And then third case, origin is 2017, X is half year base, and the Y is earning annual trend. Okay. See, Y is that is annual, but X is semi-annually. So what to be in this case? So Y equal to 2760 divided by 12 plus 212 divided by 12 into 6, not by 12, because this is a semi-annually. I repeat, 2760 divided by 12 plus 212 divided by 12 multiplied by 6. That's it. Then the last one, that is YC equal to 72 plus 12. Origin is 2015. Where X is half year based and the Y is monthly based. See, in this case Y is already in monthly, so we will do not nothing. So in this case, 72 plus 12 divided by 6 multiplied by X, that's it. All right, so question number 14 is for homework. Moving to next, question number 15, given below the monthly trend and estimate the sales. And estimate the sales for the year 2019. Origin is given 1st of July 2012. X is monthly based. Okay, monthly already monthly is given to you. Convert the above trend into as now we need to convert this monthly into annual trend. So we just need to put simply multiply by 12 and then estimate the sales for the year 2020. Okay, so let's solve this question. see yc equal to 130 plus 128x, and in this case this is the monthly trend, right? Now we need to convert this monthly trend into annual trend. So yc equal to 12 multiplied by 130 plus 144 multiplied by 1.8x, right? So that would be equal to plus 259.2x, right? So this is the way to convert the monthly trend into annual trend. Now they are asking the estimate the sales for the year 2020. Sales for the year 2020. Is already given to you. Let's change this year. Suppose the sales for the year is, that is, 2012 instead of 2020. Let's suppose this is 2012. So that means the value of x would be 8, right? Suppose this is the origin is given 2012, right? Now we need to find out or estimate the value for the year 2020. So for in the year 2020, the value of x would be 8. So yc equal to 3633.6, right? Very simple. So this was the question number 15. Now class, moving to our next topic, that is called seasonal variation. So far whatever we have done, we are purely basically dependent on the annual trend. And if we are going to analyze the seasonal, then we simply convert the annual trend into monthly, right? But the thing is that sometimes we need to specifically find out we need to simply analyze the seasonal variation. Okay, like we say that suppose if I want to know that, suppose the farmer want to know what would be the approximate in the next coming this season. So that means they must have the data like for the last 3 years, 4 years, 5 years, and on that basis they will analyze that what would be likely sale in the next upcoming season, right? So that in that case we specifically need the data, that is to find out the seasonal variation. But this again, but to find out the seasonal variation, we have the four method. The first one, that is the simple average. Second one is ratio to trend. Third one is ratio to moving average method. And the fourth one is link relative model. But for the curriculum of BCom Honors, we will simply focus on only on the one type of method, that is simply based on simple averages. Okay, so that means we will only the one particular type of measuring seasonal variation, that is called method of simple averages. We will not do the rest of the methods that are not part of the curriculum of business statistics, right? And this is a very very simple case. This is the very very simple, you can say, the method of calculating the seasonal variation. How to find out the seasonal variation? That is SI. SI basically indicate the seasonal index. Seasonal index. Suppose seasonal index for January or any month. I'm just writing the name of the month. So seasonal index for the January monthly average of January divided by average of monthly averages. Multiplied by 100. This is the way of finding out the seasonal index for the particular month. This is very, very, very simple. Alright. So let's do this with the help of one illustration. That is question number 16. Consumption of monthly electric power in millions of kilowatt hour for street lighting in a big city during the year 2016 to 2020 is given below. And the data is given on monthly basis, right? So on the basis of the monthly basis, we need to analyze the seasonal variation on the consumption of electric, right? Right? So let's understand how to do this question. See, I have already made the basic format how to solve this kind of questions. So in this question we are going to find out the seasonal indices, and the seasonal indices we are going to find out with the help of the two method, that is the two elimination method, that is the multiplicity model and the additive model. All right so first step is, that is, you need to write the data as it is that is given in the question, and then simply focus on the formula. The formula for the seasonal index for a particular month, that is, so for example, January. What we do in this case, first of all, we need to find out the average, monthly average of January particular month. So what we do, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8. First we make a total and then divide by 5 to make the monthly average of that particular month. So that means the monthly average, monthly 5-year average for the January would be 367.8, then 329.0, 321.8, 290, 270.6, 254.4, 262.2, 285.2, 310, 345.6, 369, 394.8, right? So that means we have find out the value for the denominator part. Now we need to find out the average of monthly average. That means average of average. So that means first we need to make a total of this value, that is, that would be 3800.4, and if we take the average of this, we will get 316.7. right? Now we need to find out the seasonal indices with the help of two method, that is the multiplicative model and the additive model. So how to do all this value? Simply, we will just do this, like this divided by this value in the multiplicative model, right? So this is very simple. Then, and the value would be 116.14, 103, 0.88, 101.61, 91.57, 85.44, 80.33, 82.79, 90.05, 97.88, 109.13, 116.52, 124.66. And for the additive model, what we do, we will simply take the difference. That means 367.8 minus 316.7. Alright, so the value of additive model would be 51.1, 12.3, 5.1, minus 26.7, minus 46.1, minus 62.3, minus 54.5, minus 31.5, minus 6.7, 28.9, 52.3, and the last one is 78.1. Right? So we have found out the seasonal indices in the both method monthly wise. Why monthly wise? Because we need to analyze the seasonal in indices, that is monthly wise, right? So this is the way of finding out the seasonal indices or seasonal variation. So that was question number 16. Move on to next question number 17. Assuming the trend is absent, determine if there is any seasonality in the given data or not. Year is given 2017, last one is 2020. Now in this case, the data is basically given on based on the quarterly. All right. So in the case of quarter, what we do, again, we need to simply just put up the formula. Okay. The formula for the, in this case would be, that is seasonal index is equal to quarterly averages. That means first you need to find out the average of quarter wise. And then divided by general average, that means average of quarterly average, that means, or you can say the average of average, right? And simply multiply it over. That's it. Okay. So I think you can do the question number 17. So class, with this we have finished the another chapter of business statistics, that is analysis of time series. All right. So I hope you have understood this very well. Thank you.